Hello everyone, wherever you are, welcome back to Alpha Talk Show with me, Adventino as the host and my partner, Miss Ina Safa. Today will be special for you if you like anything related to civil engineering, because in this occasion, we will discuss about major changes in the world of civil engineering with our guest stars, experts in civil engineering that will be introduced and invited by my partner. Please.
Hello everyone, nice to meet all of you. I'm sure you are familiar with our guest stars today. Yes, you are right. Actually, they have already connected with us, and let me introduce them to you. Mr. Vincent Evin Tantaplawi, Mr. Marcelino Sandi Dwi Pamungkas, and Mr. Abelard Herdinovan Elasa.
Wow, finally we can discuss with our great specialist in civil engineering's world.
How are you today, Mr. Vincent, Mr. Sandy, and Mr. Abelard?
I'm fine, totally fine.
I'm good.
Okay.
Miss Ina, what will be our discussion topic in this occasion?
Okay, our discussion is about major changes in the world of civil engineering. Civil engineering has a very influential part in the world of civil engineering. In this occasion, we will discuss three of many important parts in the world of civil engineering, i.e. environmental friendly building, health and safety at construction site, and jobs in civil engineering.
Right, Ms. Ina. We want to ask, and of course, the audiences are also curious about the views of the speakers regarding of their specialties. The quiz stars will answer according to their respective experience or can be said to be quite skilled in explaining this.
Yep, we will also discuss the changes taking place in the world of civil engineering. From the past until now, the world of civil engineering has changed a lot. These changes certainly have some impacts on the development of the civilian world. The developments that have occurred have greatly influenced the journey of the civilian world from the past to the present and even to the future, not only in terms of regulation regarding occupational safety and health, the world of civil engineering work and the building constructed, but also the experience technological developments. We want to know what the speaker think on this.
Okay. Let's start it and listen to what the speakers will tell us. I want to ask to Mr. Abelard first. How do you feel in terms of work opportunities in civil engineering world? Because it is very popular with our audience today. Of course, they are very curious about your views.
Okay. In my point of view, civil engineering is a branch of engineering that studies how to design, create not only buildings and infrastructure, but also include environment for the benefit of human life. A country can be said to be advanced if the country infrastructure is also advanced. Of course, many civil engineers are needed. This broad branch of civil engineering makes it very flexible in the world of work. Profession obtained from an expert in this field include designing, executing construction, maintaining infrastructure such as bridges, tunnels, buildings, airport, traffic, canal network system, drainage, and etc. All aspects of life are covered in the content of civil engineering science. In civil engineering, career prospects are not just about buildings. However, there are many other professions, for example, being construction consultant, quality control analyst, supervisor, and system quality control manager. Each branch of civil engineering work has its own expertise, which will be related to each other. Thank you.
Okay, then is there any change, Mr. Abelard? And what do you think about the changes?
Of course, changing by following the development of existing time. This thanks are there help solve human problems. We are required to be able to adapt to development condition, to design an infrastructure and building to be more sturdy, efficient, safe, and of course taking into account environmental safety as well. Like problem the worries human now is environmental damage. This problem have an impact on Earth, such as global warming. We civil engineers make a building not only aesthetically pleasing and sturdy, but also pay attention to its environmentally friendly aspect, such as making the building from recycled materials and from the use of natural resource and building that save electricity and water usage. I think a worker in civil engineering must take into account the future possibilities, and from this consideration, much of the work of civil engineers is facilitated by the rapid development of technology. Yes.
All right, I got the answer, and I think the audience must really understand the world of civil engineering work. Okay, we are going to the next topic, i.e. health and safety at construction site. And then we turn to Mr. Sandy. What do you think about health and safety at work in the world of civil engineering, and what are your views regarding health and safety at work sites?
Okay, thank you for time given to me. I think that occupational health and safety in the world of civil engineering is the main thing in implement a project so that work be safer and run smoothly. The development of knowledge and understanding of occupational health and safety for workers and people related to the project has progressed over time. Workers have understood the importance of understanding occupational health and safety. For example, by using project helmet, project shoes, project clothes, and other project tools. My view of occupational health and safety is a necessary and important thing in the workplace, especially in the world of civil engineering. In order to maintain the safety and health workers in the work environment, that way the risk of incident of work incident and loss of human life due to the pattern of the profession becomes smaller.
Okay. Then what do you think about these changes in the health and safety section of the work site? Are there are changes having a major impact on the world of civil engineering?
Okay. In my opinion, change in the health and safety in the workplace is that there must be change in every era and adapt to technology. Development things must be positive and change for the better. I do that change in occupational health and safety in the world of civil engineering had a big impact and will ever be. It's because if there are no change, every project will not run smoothly. There will be incident work and there may be casualties. But if there are positive changes and also knowledge of occupational health and safety, the project will run smoothly and reduce work incident. I did it. There are still a lot work incident and work, but because of change of starting to understand the importance of health and safety in the workplace, victim of work incident have disgraces. Thank you.
That's great, isn't it, Miss Ina?
Yeah.
Okay, then we are going to the last topic, i.e. environmentally friendly building. Well, of course, nowadays many people are wondering about environmentally friendly buildings that have used advanced technology. What is your view, Mr. Vincent, about environmentally friendly buildings? Because it is very attractive and has been implemented in many countries. Please.
Okay, thank you for the question. In my opinion, green building is a building that pays attention to environmental aspect or building with natural noises, so that the building does not emit emissions that are too high in reducing greenhouse effect emissions. Green building plan design example include air circulation, managing energy sources, governance of green land, material use and so on, so that the building is that is planned based on the concept of environmentally friendly doesn't give a negative effect of environment. If the concept continues to be developed, then it doesn't not close the possibility of new ideas that arise as a result of existing application and then have an impact on the preservation of nature. Thank you.
Okay, I want to ask again for Mr. Vincent, what are the differences that you felt according to environmentally friendly building system, and what do you think?
I think prior to implementation of environmentally friendly building, first, increase the impact of environmentally damage. Second, wasteful in using money. Third, health is becoming worse for the people. After the existence of environmentally friendly building system, first, life is higher. The city is a place synonymous with air pollution and pollution. The lack of trees plus the number of vehicles is the cause. Likely, green building or eco-friendly buildings can overcome this problem. Green building is also able to overcome health problems due to some air, such thickness and the room feels uncomfortable to live in. This concept is more suitable when you are in your residence, whether it's a house or an apartment. Second, recycle. You can recycle the remaining materials that can still be processed and used from the building materials on interior part of the house. This is an example of the preservation of natural resources that cannot be updated. For example, certain types of rocks, such as granite, that can be used for building materials, such as the edge of the pond on the floor of the house. Thank you.
Wow, that's a great explanation, Mr. Vincent. Okay, we have already had a lot of answers to the puzzling question of how these things can be. But to be honest, I'm still curious about something in the civil engineering world. But I don't think we still have time to discuss it again in this occasion.
Yes, you are right. I hope we can discuss it deeper in the next occasion.
Okay, thank you to our guest stars today for the time to share their opinions about major changes in civil engineering's world with us, and thank you to the loyal viewers of our talk show. And finally, don't forget to always watch Alpha Talk Show. See you in the next talk show.
Every Saturday at 6 p.m. on the In Atma TV.
See you.
Thank you.
Thank you.